Hey everybody, welcome back to Magic Orthodoxy. My name's David, and this is a deck review. Hey, today we're gonna look at the Mondrian playing cards from Got Magic. Got Magic is Tomas Pinston and Nicholas Earle. You might remember them. I've done some other card reviews for them in the past. All right, so what are the Mondrian cards? Mondrian is an artist, okay? Back in the early 20th century, he was a Dutch artist and literally changed the face of European painting forever. He had very iconic, very abstract compositions. Pretty much looks like what this tuck case looks like. Straight lines, colored rectangles, and he ended up birthing a art movement called the style. Now, you can purchase a very sophisticated, limited edition deck that's gonna bring that style to your magic, your cardistry, and even your gaming table. This beautiful tuck case is done in Mondrian's classic style. It's pretty much his artwork, a very close facsimile of his artwork, wrapped all the way around. You're also gonna have a facsimile of his signature there at the bottom done in silver foil. There's really no other writing around this tuck case if you spin this all the way around. It's very simplistic, very minimalistic, except for the bottom. The bottom's gonna have a little bit of ad copy. It says Got Magic and 1 of 5,000. And it has a little bit about Nicholas Earle and Tomas Pinston. Even the tuck flap doesn't really have anything else on it. However, if you open up the tuck case, you'll see that it is lined with silver foil just like the signature. That is pretty much it for the tuck case. Let's take a look at these cards. These cards come printed from the United States Playing Card Company, and they are done on the very thin retail stock. They do have a modern cut and air cushion finish, and if you'd like to learn more about stock, cut, or finish, you can click the link below in the description. A lot of people always ask how these cards feel and how they handle. They feel and handle great. Also, what I can tell you is how thick they are. What I do is I stick 10 of these into a caliper to give you a scientific measurement about how they compare against other cards you may have held or owned. All right, so when I stick 10 of these into the caliper, it comes to 2.74. 2.74 is a very thin stock. Okay, that is about the same as the Aurelian cards that Bicycle printed, the Killer Bees that came out, and the Regal playing cards. The back design of these cards are inspired by Mondrian's classic colors and his very elegant and clean lines. With this deck, you'll get two original jokers. It's a 1950s fashion plate, one of them wearing a Mondrian-style dress and the other one wearing the same dress but in kind of a black and gray. Also with this deck, you'll get two gaff cards. You'll get a double backer and a blank face card, which are great for magic tricks. Your ace of spades is almost a cubist shape, and then you have the Mondrian colors there in the center, and then underneath you'll have Mondrian's signature. Your pips and indices will all be completely industry standard, making them perfect for gameplay, magic, and cardistry. Your court cards are also gonna be Bicycle standard. However, they are printed in Mondrian's very bright primary colors. You're gonna have a lot of those aquas and yellows standing out. And pretty much, in fact, this entire deck, whether it be Ace of Spades or Jokers or, like I said, court cards, they're all paying homage to Mondrian's designs. All right, so that's pretty much everything I can say about the Mondrian playing cards. I'd like to thank rareplayingcards.com for allowing me to have this deck so that I could do the review for you. And if you'd like to purchase this deck for yourself or find any of your other very favorite playing cards, you can find them for purchase at rareplayingcards.com. Thanks. Bye.